I have always walked with my head held high, but there's a very big difference why I walk with my head held high now than when I did 10 years ago. My name's Hannah, and this is my story. I was the sort of person that you'd cross the street to avoid, not because of what I looked like, but because of who I was. And my friends, they weren't my friends through love, but through fear. The hard, cold-hearted person I'd become through drug addictions and alcohol abuse turned me into somebody to be feared. A liar and a thief, only looking out for myself. An angry, confused and insecure person struggling to find my place in this world. I was a gangster wannabe, trying to make a name for myself in the small town of Hereford. And I needed to feel important and respected. And I wanted to be feared. Did this bring me satisfaction? No. Did this bring me peace? No. I knew so many people. There was never any time to be alone, yet I felt lonely. Ironic, it seems. Have you ever felt lonely? I mean, that loneliness that reaches to the core of your soul and lingers. For little does man perceive what loneliness is and how far it extends. For a crowd is not company and faces are but a gallery of pictures. I had many faces, an array of masks I had collected over the years for each chapter of my life up until then. But a mask merely covers what is hiding underneath the face and doesn't help the mind or the heart of a person. Something happened to me as a young child that tormented my mind, and I tried to block out the pain and the memories through relationships, drugs, and alcohol. And it worked for some time, but I don't recall feeling any peace. Do you ever feel discontent in your life? Where you think, is this it to life? I ask myself that question so many times. There must be more. I tried everything, but nothing satisfied, nothing filled that hole, that void that every single person is born with. And then one day, I felt like I'd had enough and didn't want to live in this life anymore. I'd tried everything this world has to offer to bring fulfillment, and yet there was one thing I hadn't done. So I cried out to God and said, God, if you are there, help me. And this changed the entire course of my life forever. Did you know that Jesus said, I come to bring life, and life to its full? I thought a full life was knowing everybody, having everything, partying hard, and just enjoying life. But the full life Jesus is talking about is that fulfillment, is having love, joy, hope, and peace. Have you ever experienced true peace? The Bible describes it as peace that surpasses all understanding. It's indescribable. And that thing I mentioned that happened to me as a child, Jesus has given me peace and has restored that which was once broken. Have you ever lost hope in something? Your children, your relationship, your job, the government? I lost hope. I lost hope in everything, but then I found Jesus, and Jesus gave me hope. He gave me hope, not just for my present, but for my future. He gave me hope and he gave me contentment. I thought I'd been too bad in my life for Jesus to ever love or accept someone like me. But did you know that the Bible says that this is love? Not that we loved God, but that he loves us. And he sent his only son to die for us and to take the punishment that we deserved. Wow. Now that's truly amazing. So this was my story. From a young, messed up girl who was a bully, living life on the outside, yet on the inside was haunted by her own fear and loneliness, declaring never to marry, and certainly never to have children, who, when calling on the name of Jesus, was given a second chance, a chance to have peace, a chance to have hope, a chance to feel loved. Today, I walk with my head held high because of Jesus. Because of Jesus, I have two beautiful children whom I adore and a husband who has my heart. I'm no longer lonely because Jesus lives in me. I no longer fear because I know where I'm going. When this life ends, the new life begins.